Well, at SASE we have this workshop, and we are very proud of having that because we need it to some extent in order to build this kind of network and community of early researchers. And we think this is a very good investment for the association in order to provide young scholars a place where they can discuss their research and also the possible developments that can develop. So this is it.
Yeah, well, I would just second that. I think it just stands out to me because I go to other, you know, many other conferences. I'm kind of an interdisciplinary person, so I go to other conferences. So it stands out to me that SASE has this early career scholar workshop opportunity where I can just kind of come and not only feel the anxiety of, you know, networking and presenting at a conference, but also sort of look forward to experiencing career development and kind of rubbing shoulders with people like Roberto who have many more years than I do, and you know, who I can really learn from, not just in the strictly academic sense, but in the professional sense. And I will also add that it's especially true for me because I'm just entering my first year of the tenure track. So you know, I think that if you look around, you might find more stuff for PhD students, which was included here. But I mean, I think it's very instrumental for people like me who I've crossed the threshold, but I'm still at the beginning of my career. So I really appreciate that.
Yes, and one of the main features of the workshop is actually that we try to promote peer, say, discussion, rather than having this top-down from professors to students or PhD students or early career researchers. What we try to actually to foster is the exchanges between them. So this is one of the main things that we are actually trying to promote.
Well, I'll just say a few words about what I'm presenting. So I'm sort of presenting on a paper on the politics of low-income housing in the U.S. I'm thankful that there's a space for me to, because I come more from an urban studies background, but as I came through grad school, I identified with economic sociology, and I'm thankful that there is a stage in economic sociology where I can kind of have these kind of conversations. But I'm presenting on the politics of low-income housing, and specifically the shift to tax credits, the use of the tax code to redistribute low-income housing subsidies and away from directly provided federal programs. And I'm thinking about that within the context of racial politics in particular, because as an anti-poverty program, low-income housing is a really racially charged, contentious field. And I think that scholars haven't thought about the shift to these low visibility kinds of policy instruments in that kind of field. And that's what I'm thinking about in this paper.
Yes. Well, I'm presenting a paper on European social dialogue and European economic governance, because my main research area is actually industrial relations. And what I'm interested in looking at now is how these European level developments are influencing national development and actually how they interact. And what I'm looking at basically now is how the development in the European social dialogue, especially which lately try to promote some sort of involvement on national social partners, also at national level in the policy making process, how they are actually influencing what is happening at national level, especially because what is going on lately at national level is some weakening of industrial relations institutions. So my main question is whether these two trends or trajectories are somehow viable or actually sustainable. Because on one side there is a promotional effort to provide social partners to have more space in policy making, whereas on the other side, at national level, some indicators point to the weakening of industrial relations and social partners. Is this possible? Is this viable in some extent?
About coming back to SASE, that's something that I really absolutely plan on doing in the future. I think I wanted to come, as I was telling Alberto, I wanted to come a few years ago, but I had travel travel mishaps. So I'm glad that I finally made it, and I certainly plan to come in the future.
But have you already presented in your session or not?
I haven't. Yes, tomorrow.
Because it would be nice to understand whether it's different from the workshop. Whether you have different opportunities to present your research there, different kind of feedback.
It is also a bit different too.
It shall be different, but. I mean, both of them are, I think, a good opportunity.
Yeah, I agree.
What made you want to get more involved in sort of kind of the planning side of SASE?
Sometimes you don't plan that. I mean, it just happens. And for myself, it happened because I had to organize one SASE Congress. And that was very, very interesting, very, very involving. And that's why I also could appreciate all the different elements that you are behind the scene about organizing Congress, how you have to organize the program, the different panels, how actually you have to provide people that are coming some infrastructure or services, and I think this is also, I mean, to some extent rewarding. So I think being part of the organization side is very nice as well.
Yes.